I have been waiting for this for quite some time. The DJI Spark has arrived. I may have said that too fast. The DJI Spark has arrived. I actually probably could have had this a week or two ago, but I didn't just want the Spark. I wanted the bundle. So what I have here today is the DJI Spark Fly More Combo. We'll get into what all that combo entails here in just a minute, but basically, the DJI Spark is DJI's new, very consumer-friendly drone, in that it is about the size of the palm of your hand. I mean, the entire thing fits in this box, which does technically fit in the palm of my hand, and this contains more than just the drone. This is a bunch of stuff in this box. Now again, I could have had this a few weeks ago. You could buy this, just the drone itself, just a few weeks ago. It's $500 just for this drone, but I wanted more stuff in it. So it was $700, and it does come with, we'll talk about what it comes with later. Let's open it up and take a look. I guess first I should mention, it did come with this included in the box, SanDisk Ultra 16GB, up to 80 megabytes a second, micro SD card, which should be very handy. But inside of the box for the Fly More combo, there's a shoulder bag. Very hard to show it on camera because it's very dark. And actually it looks like for this combo, the majority of the stuff is gonna be contained in this bag out of the gate. Silica gel, lots of foam. Got a nice little pocket in here that you can carry some spare propellers and whatnot in. You have part of the charger here, the other part of the charger. Couple of sets of prop guards, which I'm actually not even gonna open because I probably will not use them. The controller, which actually, if you buy it after the fact, is like a $150 add-on and looks very similar to the one for the DJI Mavic Pro, except it doesn't have a little display here. And it has a sport mode switch right here in the center. And whereas the Mavic has the micro USB plug here on the side for you to plug into and use with your device, it looks like the plug is here on the Spark. Although I don't know if you actually have to plug the phone into this one. We'll get back to that. This also came with a micro USB cable and a 3-port charging plate, which should plug into this charging brick. Because when you buy the Spark on its own, you don't actually get a way to charge it other than just using a micro USB charging cable. And I will say, this is a very nice little bag. I don't know if I can ever see myself really using it because the whole point of the Spark is to be small enough that you don't have to have a special bag for it, but this is very sleek, very svelte, so maybe, we'll see. And moving back over to the box, there's a small box inside of here. It says instructions, which holy poop, has a whole bunch of documentation in there. I don't know if I've ever seen as much documentation. Remote controller, battery charging hub, propeller guards, you've got guides for everything. It's thicker than a deck of playing cards. And then last, but certainly not least, and the way that I actually would intend to carry this around most of the time, the DJI Spark itself. So this is the styrofoam case that every one of them will come in. This is what you would get if you just bought it at Best Buy or on Amazon or DJI's website or wherever else, and I'll try to have links to all of them down below. There we go. So inside of this box, this is a couple of propellers and a couple more propellers, which actually, again, these are going to come in the Fly More combo, as well as this spare battery. And there are the specs on the battery if you really want to know more about it. And of course, here is the drone itself. So as you can see, in the palm of my hand, the drone pretty much fits. It is just slightly smaller than a cell phone in terms of the body. There's the Samsung Galaxy S8 for comparison, so it's quite a bit smaller than that. In terms of thickness, of course, obviously it's much, much thicker. It does come with propellers pre-installed. The legs don't fold up or anything like the Mavic does. And it is very small and compact. I can't say that enough. Gotta take all these little stickers off. This little section here is where it's actually going to watch. That's the other really cool thing about this I haven't mentioned yet. Once you take off with this, you technically don't even have to use a controller or your phone to control it. You can control this with your hand. So once you hold it out in front of you and you press the button to turn it on, if you hold the button again, do a certain combination of button presses, you can actually have it recognize your face and then use your hand to control where it flies. We may try that in a minute as well. Gotta take this sticker off the back. It's giving you info here about how to turn it on though. It says charge the battery the first time to activate it. Power on, press once, then press and hold for 2 seconds to turn it on. And then under this little Spark logo, we got the micro SD card slot as well as micro USB. So if you want to, this can technically be all contained where you charge it from micro USB. You leave the battery in it all the time. It's a really neat little package. I can't say enough good things about it. And I've never even flown one. Now I did pay for this out of my pocket. I've never actually received a free drone from DJI. DJI, if you happen to see this video, I'm more than willing to take a look at your stuff. Feel free to send stuff my way. But for this size, it, like I said, is packed with sensors. It's got a 1080p camera on the front of it here with a stabilized gimbal. Although the gimbal, it only does two directions, so it does this way and it goes up and down. So it doesn't do the three axis like a lot of other DJI drones, but still pretty good. It's got a bottom facing camera here as well as some sensors to help with landing and flying indoors. So perhaps not as many sensors as the Phantom 4 or anything like that. Possibly not even as many as the Mavic Pro, which I still haven't finished the video about. Sorry. This came in, I got really excited. And I just noticed that this sort of matches my shirt. Very cool. There are a bunch of different colors of this available as well. There's blue, obviously, and white, and yellow, and red, and green, I think. And as I think I mentioned before as well, there are multiple ways to control it. So you can control it just with your hand, like I showed. You can use the controller, or just using Wi-Fi, using your phone, using the DJI Go 4 app. And it looks like I will have to actually plug this in to get the battery to activate and charge before anything else can happen. So let me go ahead and do that. We'll see about getting it paired up and do a quick test flight with it, let you see how it looks, how the video quality is. Now, again, as I mentioned, it's 1080p. Video, so it's not 4K. It's not even 1080p 60 like the rest of this video is going to be, and that's a bummer in my opinion, but for the size and for the relatively reasonable price tag, I'm willing to make that sacrifice. I think for vloggers, this could actually be a game changer, and from what I've seen from a lot of other vloggers, it has been. So let me charge this battery and we'll be right back.
Well, the Spark is charging, and I think I've got everything just about ready to go. So I've got the DJI Go 4 app here on my phone. I'll go ahead and turn on the controller by pressing and then holding the button. There you go. And then we'll turn on the Spark by pressing and holding the button. And in theory, since I ordered this as a combo, they're paired up to each other. And basically all I had to do was go into the Wi-Fi settings on my phone and make sure it's paired up with the controller. There's a Wi-Fi username and password on the back of the controller. So once I go into my Wi-Fi settings and select this Spark RC, I've given it the password already, and it should connect. You see, we do have a green light on the controller, which means that we are connected to the drone. And then when we go back over to the Spark app, hit enter device. It says weak image transmission signal. It's just having problems because we're indoors. There we go. It looks like it's actually caught up at this point. So if I hold it up here in front of my face, you can see me and all that fun stuff. So I think at this point, we'll go outside. We'll get some GPS locked on it, get the compass calibrated and everything, and go for a quick flight. Let's take a look at the footage.
I've just finished my first flight with the DJI Spark. I actually tried it two different ways. I used the traditional controller-based method, and then I also tried the hand movements. I didn't have a camera out there for that, sorry. I'm gonna say it, if you're gonna do the hand-controlled movements, you might wanna do it in a large open area. As you may have noticed from the footage earlier, the area in my backyard is, well, it's covered in trees and playthings for the kids and whatnot, so there's not a whole lot of area now to fly this. So I would highly recommend getting a larger open field. But at the same time, as you might have noticed, I don't even know if it'll show up on the video footage, once I got about 100 feet away, the Wi-Fi signal started to cut out, which meant that my phone started dropping video. That could have been because I was behind the house and the drone was on the other side. I don't know. It's something I'm going to have to keep working with, and I may want to try different phones with this just to see if that makes a difference. But realistically speaking, it's all supposed to be relayed through the controller in this case, and it seemed to be having problems with that. Even as close as like 10 feet away, it was having problems dropping the video signal. And I've heard of a lot of people just using Wi-Fi mode only on this with their phones, having it fly away. So I've got a bit of a mixed opinion of it right now. I really love the size of it. The battery life is about, it's supposed to be about 15 to 20 minutes. Cannot remember off the top of my head exactly what it is. I think it's 20 minutes. And I think that's as far as I'm gonna go with it. I like the video quality out of it. I like the shape and size, and I like the battery life. I even went as far as to put it in sport mode, and I think I captured some of that. And this thing kicks some butt. I mean, it really will go pretty fast out there. Very, very fast and maneuverable, and the gimbal does its best to kind of accommodate that. But if you'd like to see follow-up on this or anything else about it, definitely let me know down in the comments. My biggest concern is just the Wi-Fi dropouts. I'm going to see if I can work on that to try to get it working better. It might involve switching it over to 2.4 gigahertz because it defaulted to 5.8. It might be any number of things, but let me know what you guys think of it down in the comment section below. Do you think it's worth $500 just for the drone, $700 for the entire combo pack? Did you like the quality of the footage? You'll just have to let me know. But thank you guys as always for watching. Hit that thumbs up if you liked it and subscribe if you have not already so you get notified when I put out new videos about drones and other technology items and things that go on in my life. And I'll see you again next time.